hope we're here long enough to find out.
I hope I'm here long enough to screw myself in the floor.
Why don't you go to bed?
Don't you want to hear the details, Macca? Guaranteed to keep you in wet dreams for a week. Oh, God, I was twice as hot thinking of how Spud would like to be getting his rocks off with a screwing Lou in the loo. Hey, Macca, that's poetry. Rhymes.
I'm going to bed.
I was putting a good word for you, Macca. I'm moving. Onwards and upwards. You get me drift? Oh, Lou's okay. She wants it too bad. Now, Pixie, all legs and gooey eyes. I could rub my hands up those thighs till she begged. Shut up, Frank! Hit a nerve, did I, Patty? Tell you what, you be a good boy, and I might let you watch.
Hmm? Oh, that's enough, and knock it off!
Oh, take it easy. I was kidding.
You're about as funny as a kick in the crutch. Now, I don't care how many women you have. If they're stupid enough, it just serves them right. But you lay one finger on that girl and I'll put you out of action permanently. And I'm not kidding.
When I saw him first and I wish he'd just stay out of my way.
Why don't you leave him alone? Bloody been growing on him like a wart.
Oh, yeah, well, look, I can't see him falling over himself to get to you.
Well, how can he? You're such a bloody great lump.
Oh, thanks. I saw him first.
Big deal.
If you two could possibly drag yourselves away from such intellectual conversation, it's time for Ben.
All I'm asking is don't cramp my style.
Well, you don't have to worry about that. Matt and me ever find your bloody style, we wouldn't touch it with a 10-foot pole.
Where's the new Queen of Wentworth, Desmond?
Check the toilet block. That's where she feels most at home.
Oh, Desmond, that's no way to talk about your top dog.
I wouldn't blink if I were you, Miss Ferguson. You might miss something.
About time, too. You know, I'd say the honeymoon is just about over.
Stuff on their faces. They've got work to do.
Ladies first.
Now I've heard everything. Desmond, a lady.
Shut up, Keane, and serve the breakfast.
Now, come on, Myra, let me do him a good deed for the day.
Look, I'm not a little old lady, and you're not a Boy Scout, so cut the good deeds. I don't need that crap around here, and I don't need handouts.
Well, if you can't tell the difference between a handout and good manners, I'm sorry for you.
How can you be to blame me now? It's your husband that's beating you.
Because I'm a bad wife. Not give husband child.
But that's not necessarily your fault.
Yeah, well, I mean, maybe it's his fault. Maybe he's the one who can't have children.
Yeah.
Husband? This cannot be. His shame of wife.
Yeah, it's a shame, all right. It's a crying shame. You wouldn't even be in here in the first place if you hadn't stolen that car to get away from the bastard.
Better I be here than shame family.
Oh, that's crazy.
Not to your meal, it isn't.
God.
Keep it down. I don't want the screws to see you talking.
Yeah, well, if some bloke did that to me, I'd just find someone else.
Yeah, well, good for you.
No, this is not permitted. I never go out of house.
Never?
Never. Without husband.
Must be crazy.
No, not crazy, love. Just different. Oh, damn, I have sugar. Anyone got any sugar?
Yeah, you can have this.
Put it down, Matt. If she wants it, she can get it a still.
My brother.
And she was only pretending to be nice so that we'd make her top dog. And as soon as we did, oh gosh, Ray, it was terrible. She was so nasty to everybody, she didn't care one little bit about it.
Listen, babe, you're a sweetie, but sometimes you get things mixed up. Reb is good. Heavens, I should know. She saved my job, didn't she?
No, no, no. She would only have done that for a reason. Now think about it.
Perhaps you're right, but... No, it can be. It must be a mistake.
Well, poor Marlene wasn't a mistake when Reb gave her all those terrible drugs. I mean, she could have died.
My Reb? When she was so sick, Reb did that?
That's what I've been trying to tell you.
Ooh, this is terrible. I believed her. I feel like a...
A silly sausage. I know. Don't feel bad about it. I mean, she fooled all of us.
Nobody makes a fool out of me. Nobody.
It would be good if we got there. The chuckle said we can't do any work today because all machines are broken down.
That'd be impossible. Bobby here'd have it fixed in no time.
Yeah, that's a problem with living with a genie.
Now, don't you worry about a thing. Keep quiet the way you've been doing, and we won't give you away.
Thank you. You are free.
Oh, my God. Check the other doors, Jude.
Yeah.
Oh, no, not me. Walk me.
Why would anyone do something like this?
Not very hard to figure.
Well, it's a mess. I guess they're all like that.
Right, what are you up to now?
Oh, be our guest. This is just a sample. We've got others to show you if you don't like this one. Hey, some bastard's given me celery all going over.
Surprise, surprise.
Well, you better get it cleaned up and hurry. You've still got work quotas to fill.
There go, our cell's been wrecked. Aren't you going to do anything about it?
You want to tell me who did it? Fair enough. I'll just make out a report to the governor. But it's still got to be cleaned up, so get stuck into it.
Lou? Oh, she would have had something to do with it. She's not pulling the strings, though. I think Keane has just declared war.
This is ridiculous. I can walk. I have to when I get out of the car anyway.
Now, knock it. I'd swap with you.
Besides, you're not nearly as strong as you think you are, Mrs. Morris.
If you need me, even if it's just for a chat, give me a call and I'll come round.
Thanks. But I think I have to be the one to make that decision.
Let's get you into the car.
Nice of her to give free drugs if you like that sort of thing, but honestly, I don't think you should encourage people in their bad habits, do you?
What's the matter with her?
Nothing's wrong with her. Excuse me.
I've got a little job for you.
I already have a job. Now let me get on with it.
You've got a job because I saved it for you. Don't forget that. Now I did you one hell of a favor. It's your turn.
What sort of favor?
Oh, thinking of opening a little shop. Nothing fancy. Just a few pills, grass, bottles of booze. You're going to bring them in.
No.
Now, you listen to me. If I hadn't written that letter, you'd be out in your ear by now. Maybe it's time I told the freak she can have you.
You're a mean, vicious little bitch. I've got the letter, not you, so don't make any threats. You fooled everyone, even me, but you shouldn't have hurt poor Marlene. You know what I think of you? That's what I think of you. You're a pusher. Get off my way.